Okay, here's our hydrocyclone and dewatering auger to make this work effectively for getting 80 to 100 mesh off the top of the hydrocyclone. It's going to need some more water feed off the table than we can get with our hose right here. But the principle works really well. Okay, you can reach down and get some of that mud that's coming up out of this. The undersize of the tailings. This is really quite fine material. So we're guessing this is probably 150-200 mesh quartz that, and gang that's coming out in the tailings. Here is the jaw crusher with the stand. It's an 8x8 yellow hopper, which will feed into the conveyor laying here on the floor behind it. The conveyor mounts right there under the jaw crusher. This is the impact mill, 16 horse gas motor for power. Here's the yellow feed hopper, and here's the inside paddles there. We've added AR plate armor for the case, and then the paddles are AR plate, 3/8 inch thick, and these are symmetrical so they can be flipped over this way and that way, so you have 4 wear surfaces per paddle. We like to run it wet to keep the dust down, but it will run just fine dry. But we've designed the impact mill discharge to feed right onto the shaker table, and then the shaker table tailings will feed into the top of the hydrocyclone, which then will classify the material depending on your ore liberation size, and the overs, which come out the top of the pipe, can be refed in to your crushing system. Thanks for watching, and check out our website, mbmmllc.com.